Dear friends, I greet you all in Jesus' almighty name. I welcome you to this program of Sublime Solutions. Today, I wish to deal with an important topic, personality decomposition caused by depravity. The doctrine of total depravity asserts that people are, as a result of the fall, not inclined or even able to love God wholly with their heart, mind, and strength, but rather are inclined by nature to serve their own will and desires and reject the rule of God. So, dear friends, what I want to tell you is, because of the fall of humanity, Adam and Eve's disobedience and the whole humanity fell in sin, we have inclination towards evil in this world. But at the same time, Jesus died for the whole world, and it is God's will that all should be saved. At the same time, when the gospel is given to people, some people would not want to be saved. They reject the Lord Jesus Christ and the gospel. Why? They are inclined to follow the sins of this world. It is their choice. Jesus will not compel anybody to go to heaven. He will open the way. He will come and knock at the door. It is imperative that people who hear the word of God should open their hearts and allow Jesus to come in. So the choice of the people is very important. When people reject the gospel, what happens is they go into despicable degradation and decomposition of their personality. We have body, soul, and spirit. We are tripartite in nature. When people are not willing to come to God, they go down deeper into degradation and personality decomposition sets in. So, what we have to understand is salvation is today. Tomorrow never comes. The more you delay, the more harder your heart will become. It is imperative, friends, that we understand the concept of personality decomposition caused by depravity. So, I want to place before you 8 sinful vices that bring in personality decomposition. After explaining 8 sinful vices that bring in personality decomposition, I will explain to you the remedy for these vices, to overcome these things and live for the Lord. The first point that I want to place before you is voyeurism. Voyeurism is, it is the practice of gaining sexual pleasure by looking at others when they are naked, are involved in sexual activity. David did this when David was king in Israel. When the people were going for war, when the kings were going for war, he did not go for war. He was just sleeping in the terrace during daytime. And when he got up in the evening, when he looked down, he saw a woman and she was taking bath and he fell in sin. It begins with voyeurism, looking at something that is evil. So the word of God says, lust of the eyes, lust of flesh, and pride of life. They are not of God, they are of this world. So what happened was, when David fell in sin, when he looked at Bathsheba, he sinned with her, and then to keep his own name as a great king, he killed her own husband. So this is what's happening, friends. Many people are involved in this voyeurism. They long to look at negative things. They long to look at dirty things. This will bring in personality decomposition. The second point that I want to place before you is dangers of pornography. Many people are addicted to pornography, addicted to movies, serials. Now, when married people look at dirty movies or when they look at pornography, I call it mutually agreed adultery. This is what happens in many families. This results in breakdown in family unity, ushering in emotional and physical violence. Children are greatly affected when parents have disunity and engage in emotional violence. This is something that we all should understand very clearly. One young woman who was married to her husband after 1 or 1.5 years, she connected with me and she was telling her problems. Her husband was a person who was addicted to pornography. He'll keep the laptop open, looking at the porn site, and tell his wife, "You are not as beautiful as these images." And the family broke down. I don't know how many of you are addicted to pornography. If you're addicted to pornography as an unmarried person, wake up to the reality that in future, you're going to jeopardize your own family. It is imperative that you humble yourself and come to the Lord Jesus Christ and get cleansed by Him. And if you're a married person, if you're watching porn, you're bringing curses into your own family. So, dear friend, these are vices that are brought in by depravity of human heart. We must understand these realities and we must be able to come closer to God. Now, many people feel loving somebody and marrying them or maybe arranged marriages is enough. Everything will be like a fairy tale finish. No, you need to have Jesus Christ in your heart, and also He must be the center of your own family life. He only can unite you. Of course, problems may come. He can unite you both. He can make you live victorious lives in your own home so that your children will be greatly blessed. The third vice that had been brought in by depravity is homosexuality and lesbianism. During these postmodern times, many countries have legalized homosexuality and lesbianism. It is a deep depravity that causes personality decomposition. If you read Romans 1st chapter 24th to 28th verses, here St. Paul explains, they exchanged the truth of God for the lie. For this reason, God gave them up to vile passions. For even their women exchanged the natural use for what is against nature. Likewise, also the men, leaving the natural use of women, burned their lust for one another, men with men committing what is shameful, and receiving them in themselves penalty of their error, which was due. And even as they did not like to retain God in their knowledge, God gave them over to a debased mind to do these things with greediness. Now, dear friends, we must be careful to understand the eventuality of this habit. Many countries have legalized it. Okay, there are people who involve themselves in these evil habits of homosexuality and lesbianism. If you are a person who is enslaved by this vice that has been brought in by depravity of human heart, it is better that you wake up. It is time for you to wake up. Quite a few years ago, one young woman whom I knew, she went to her pastor and said, "Pastor, please look for a husband for me." So the pastor was supposedly a prophet. He prayed and then prophesied and said, "Here is a young man, you marry him." That young man was a very handsome young man. They got married. For 1 year, he never touched her. You know why? He was a homosexual. The family was broken. If you are involved in these evil ways of homosexuality or lesbianism, it is time for you to repent and turn to God. If not, definitely you land in hellfire. The fourth evil that has been brought in by depravity of human heart is pedophilia. Pedophilia is a psychiatric disorder in which an adult or an older adolescent experiences a primary or exclusive sexual attraction to prepubescent children. So psychologists say, or psychiatrists say, it is a psychiatric disorder. Is it a sickness? I look at it as a depravity of sinful nature when people willfully reject the victory that has been brought in by Jesus Christ. I tell you, friends, there are pedophiles who abuse children and kill them. They are led by the evil spirits. They are killers. They are led by the evil spirits. There are fathers who look at their own daughters with lustful eyes. Sometime back, one woman, married woman, she connected with me and said, "Uncle, my husband is looking at our own daughter, 4-year-old daughter, with lustful eyes. When she gives birth to her own daughter, their husband looks at the little baby, little child, with lustful eyes, a so-called believer." We must understand the depravity of human heart and understand that a person who is not right before God in their own heart can deviate from the truth of God and descend down into personality decomposition and bring in curses in their own family lives. Vice that is brought in by depravity of human heart is use of sex toys. Many marriages fail because there is sexual disparity among the partners. Even people come together in marriage, it is God and the Holy Spirit who can bless them. If they are able to keep Christ as the center of their lives, they will be able to enjoy one another in their personal lives. Sex within marriage is a blessing from God. It is holy. So, dear friends, what happens is when people have sexual disparity, they don't respect one another, they don't try to satisfy the other person, they long to be satisfied with their partner for themselves only. When this happens, what happens is the one partner is not able to be satisfied, they look for sex toys. One woman who had lost her husband, maybe he left her, this particular woman heard my messages and Nambike Television, and she connected with me for prayer. And she was telling, I do not have a life partner, so shall I buy sex toy online and use it? I said, no. You look to God in prayer. The Lord can give you a life partner if you're right before God. Humble yourself. Let there be no barrier between you and God. And I guided her and told her that she must come closer to God and God will have a remedy for her. Another married woman who has a few children. She connected with me and said that her husband is a very hard person, very cruel man. He comes and gets his satisfaction. He doesn't take time to satisfy her. So she was telling, Uncle, shall I go for a sex toys? Or shall I? She said that one of her friends who had the same problem told her, it seems, you can imagine things about some other men, some other handsome men, and do masturbation. So this woman was asking me whether she can go for these things. I said, no. You have your own husband. He may not really understand your own sexual needs, but what you need to understand is God can help you. Come closer to God, talk to your own husband, pray together. The Lord can enhance your own faith. Going for sex toys or doing masturbation is not going to bless your own family. So definitely there are people who are involved in this type of acts and they destroy their own personality. Personality decomposition sets in. The sixth point that I want to place before you is zoophilia and bestiality. Zoophilia is sexual attraction of a human towards animal is called zoophilia, which may involve the experience of sexual fantasies about the animal. Real sexual contact with animal is called bestiality. I tell you friends, many people have pets in their own home. Dogs or cats are there. There's nothing wrong in it. They are animals. They do not have soul. They have no soul, okay? They are animals. They behave because of instinct. When they die, they have no soul to go to heaven. Many people develop fantasy. They develop attraction towards animals, their own pets. So sex between humans and animals is illegal in many countries and it is legalized in quite a few other countries. In quite a few countries it is legalized. But before God it is wrong. It is sinfulness. So zoophilia is attraction towards animals and bestiality is sinning with animals. Look at the word of God. If you read Exodus 22nd chapter 19th verse, there the word of God says, whoever lies with an animal shall surely be put to death. A person who sins with an animal should be put to death. And if you read Leviticus 18th chapter 23rd verse, you shall not mate with an animal to defile yourself with it, nor shall any woman stand before an animal to mate with it. It is perversion. So the word of God very clearly tells what will happen to people who are involved in this type of zoophilia, attraction towards animals and also bestiality. Leviticus 20th chapter 16th verse says, if a woman approaches an animal and mates with it, you shall kill the woman and the animal. They shall surely be put to death. Their blood is upon them. I tell you friends, many people involved in this type of activities. There are many people who have various pets, it is okay, but some of them hug them, fondle them, lick them, allow them to lick themselves. It is zoophilia. It will go into bestiality. They'll go and commit sin with the animals and they'll dirty themselves. God will punish them unless they repent before God. One man whose wife left him connected with me for counseling and he told me that his wife used to take a big dog, maybe a Labrador or big dog. And when she goes into restroom, when she goes into bathroom, she takes the animal and goes. She was sinning with that animal. This is what happens in many families. When people are involved in this type of zoophilia, what happens is they go into bestiality and it is terrible sin before God. The seventh point, the seventh vice that has been brought in by depravity of human heart is gerontophilia. This is a situation in which young people are most strongly aroused by the elderly and so it is at the opposite end of spectrum of pedophilia. So pedophilia is elderly people, adults, they try to sin with the small children. And here we see gerontophilia. So this is found in many places. How to understand this? We all have sinful nature. But when we come to the Lord Jesus Christ, our sins are forgiven. But at the same time, sinful nature continues to be there in our lives. St. Paul wails, if you read 7th chapter of Romans, there he says, what I want to do, I am not able to do. What I would not want to do, I am doing. It is not that I am doing it. It is sin that dwells in me. What shall I do? He wails. Who can deliver me from this body of sin and death? Then he says in 8th chapter, first 2 verses, there is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, who do not walk after the flesh, but according to the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free from the law of sin and death. So dear friends, once we are saved, our sins are forgiven. Holy Spirit comes in, sinful nature will be there. If we are not able to control the sinful nature by the continuing filling of the Holy Spirit, what happens is the sinful nature pokes its ugly nose out. So in that situation, they are attracted by the young people. Young people long for sex with the elderly people. Elderly people also look for that. What is needed? We must have real prayer life, obedience to God's word, and be filled by the Holy Spirit on a daily basis. So, aging will not bring spiritual maturity automatically. What is needed is we have to spend quality time in prayer on a daily basis so that we will be able to understand our own heart condition and control the old nature, the sinful nature, by the help of the Holy Spirit. John in his epistle 1 John 3rd chapter, he says, what manner of love the Father hath bestowed upon us, that we should be called the children of God. We know that we are the children of God. We do not know how we will be in future. But when Jesus comes back, we see him as he is, and we shall be translated into his likeness. He who has his hope in him purifies him as he is pure. So, dear friends, sinful nature will continue to be in us till we meet Jesus. What is the responsibility that we have? We like to control our sinful nature by the power of the Holy Spirit. We cannot control it by our own effort. So, this is very much important, my dear friends. The 8th and the last vice that I want to place before you is thanatophilia or necrophilia. It is also called as necrophilism, necrolagnia, necrocoitus, necroclesis. What happens is, this is very horrible to hear, okay? Necrophilia or thanatophilia is sexual attraction towards or sexual act involving corpses, dead bodies. So it is also called as paraphilia. So dear friends, I have read about people who kidnap others, kill them and have sex with them. So we must be very careful to understand this situation that happens in the lives of people. How can man degrade himself or herself into this situation? How can humans, men and women, degrade themselves to this situation? As I told you, this is personality decomposition brought in by depravity of human heart. Years back, there was an actress in India who used to act in very dirty scenes in the movies. And after she left the movie field, after her chances were not there, she became very poor and she entered into, lot of problems. She committed suicide. Her body was kept in a mortuary. One man tried to sin with the body. Just look at the decomposition of personalities. So, dear friends, I have placed before you 8 vices that have been brought in by human depravity. I want to close with a remedy. Today is the day of salvation. The more you delay, your heart becomes more harder. You may descend down into personality decomposition. You may go deeper and deeper into the sinful nature that you have. And you'll destroy yourself and you'll destroy others. Jesus loves you. Turn to him today before it is too late. Jesus is calling you to come to him. So offer your whole personality on the altar. Your body, soul and spirit. We have our body with 5 senses, we have our mind, we have our inner person, the subconscious mind or the spirit, the whole personality. Lay the whole personality on the altar. Let me read from Romans 12 chapter, first 2 verses. I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service. And do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is good and acceptable in the and do God's perfect will. So dear friends, this is imperative. This is what you should do. Present your body, soul and spirit on the altar. The altar of God is holy, and anything that touches the altar shall be holy. No fire of God will come upon empty altar. When you lay your body, soul and spirit on the altar as a living sacrifice on daily basis, the anointing of the Holy Spirit will come upon you. You will be totally transformed. So dear friends, what is expected of you? Let me read 1 Thessalonians 5th chapter verses 16 to 24. Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, and in everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Do not quench the spirit, do not despise prophecies, test all things, hold fast what is good. Abstain from every form of evil. I spoke to you about 8 vices. Abstain from every form of evil. Now may the God of peace himself sanctify you completely, and may your whole spirit, soul and body be preserved blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. He who calls is faithful, who also will do it. So dear friends, I told you about our responsibilities. When you humble yourself before the Lord, spend quality time in prayer. Quench not the spirit. Spend time in prayer, and God gives you a very good promise. Now may the God of peace himself sanctify you completely, and may your whole spirit, soul and body be preserved blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. He who calls you is faithful, he also will do it. So dear friends, I spoke to you about the personality decomposition brought in by depravity of human heart. Let us not pose off as if we are better, as if we are great, when our heart is full of evil. What we need to understand is, come to Jesus, receive his salvation. Let me close with the testimony of St. Augustine. He was a person who was living in the 4th century. As a young person, he was a very debaucherous person, and he was living a very miserable life. And his mother, her name was Monica. She was a very praying woman, and she used to pray and plead before the Lord for the salvation of her own son. She thought shifting him to another place from the place where they were living would change his life. So she shifted their abode to Milan, a particular place called Milan. And as they were there, he got into a wrong company. He was sinning with a woman, and he was feeling very depressed one day. His mother was praying, and he was in a park, and it's a park bench, stone bench was there. He was sitting in that bench and thinking about his own life. Suddenly what happened was, he heard a voice of a small girl who was running along the next part of the wall, and the girl was telling, take and read, take and read. As Augustine heard the voice of the little girl to take and read, he found a parchment near him in that stone bench. He opened it, and he found a verse from the scriptures. Somebody has written something and then kept it there. It was Romans 8 chapter, first 2 verses. There is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, who do not walk according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free from the law of sin and death. When he read these words, something happened in his heart. He was totally transformed. The law of Jesus Christ has made me free from law of sin and death. He was totally transformed. Joy of the Lord came into his heart. He became a different person. The next day, as he was walking down the road, he was looking elsewhere and walking. Suddenly he saw a person coming towards him, and that it was the girl with whom he was in sin few days back before his salvation. She came before him, took hold of his shoulder and said, Augustine, don't you know me? You know what he did? He pushed her aside and said, not I, not I, but Christ in me. So dear friends, this is what is needed. You may be experiencing personality decomposition because of depravity, but don't be scared. There is victory for you. There is a remedy for you. Jesus is there. The law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus will make you totally free. So Augustine, who was an evil person, became a Saint Augustine. He was one of the greatest theologians and a great man of God who lived in the 4th century. As I told you, friends, there is personality decomposition caused by depravity, but there is always victory in Jesus Christ. May the Lord help you this day to receive the blessings from the Lord. Maybe in your own life you are not involved in all these things. There may be somebody whom you know who are involved in these things. You can share these messages to them so that you will guide them and help them to come closer to the Lord. The Lord bless you this day and every day to come. Amen.